Lesson three is about logarithms, and we have not learned about logarithms before, so this is going to be brand new stuff. In this video, I'm going to give you an introduction to logarithms, and then we'll spend some more time on it in class. So, first thing you're going to do is learn how to write a logarithmic equation into exponential form, because the exponential form is what you're used to. Once it's in exponential form, then you will evaluate the logarithm from its exponential form. Finally, we will change an exponential equation into logarithmic form. So a logarithm will look something like this. And if you were to read that to someone, you would read it like this: log base b of x is y. So to give you an example, let's say we had log base 5 of 25 is 2. How you would read it? The rules for writing a logarithm are these: b has to be a positive number. The base number cannot be 0 and it cannot be negative. B can also not be 1. So you can have b as a fraction, say 1/2, 1/4, but it can't be negative. It can't be exactly 1. It can be more than 1. And the x value here has to be greater than 0. So x cannot be negative either. The logarithm right here, the y value, is the exponent that b requires to be equal to x. So if you look at exponential form right here, if I have a logarithm such as this one that I started out with, in order to calculate my answer here, which is the y value, the answer here to y is the exponent on the base that makes it equal x. So 5 to the second power equals 25. So that's how I know that y here is equal to 2. If y equals b to the x and y equals log base b of x, then these two things would be inverse functions. So what you should notice here is they both have the same letter b as a base. The left side has b as a base with an exponent. The right side has b as a base on the logarithm. Those are the same letter b. And then the exponent here is actually the y value here because it's an inverse function. You switch x with y. And then in the inverse function, the y and the x are switched over here. But the b's are the same base. So all that stuff I was telling you on the previous page is going to be used here. It should make more sense as you start to use it. So, first thing we're going to do is take each of these logarithms on the left. We will rewrite them in exponential form. From exponential form, then we will be able to calculate the answer. So, 3 is our base here. So, in exponential form, we have 3 to some power y will equal 9. So, mentally, we calculate and find that 3 squared is 9. So the answer to our logarithm here is 2. Okay, in the second example, we have our base number is 5. So that means 5 to the y power equals 1. Anything to the 0 power is 1. So we know the answer to this logarithm is 0. In the next one, we have base of 10. So 10 to the y power equals 10. Well, if 10 is to the first power, then it would equal 10. So our answer here is 1. Example D, we have a base number of 10 again. So we have 10 to the y power equals 0.1. Now, this is a little bit more challenging because it's not obvious right up front what the answer would be. So let's change this to say 10 to the y power equals the fraction 1/10 instead of the decimal 1/10. And so from this, you can see that if you made a reciprocal out of the 10, you would get 1/10. So if y were negative 1, 10 to the negative 1, make a reciprocal, we get 1/10. So the answer to our logarithm is negative 1. In the last example, we have a base of 1/2. So 1/2 to the y power equals 2. Again, we can see that a reciprocal will do the trick here. So if y is negative 1, 1/2 turns into its reciprocal. So the answer here is negative 1. Okay, that's as far as I want to go with this introduction, and we're going to do multiple examples in class, so you should come prepared to work as a whole group instead of as individuals, and we'll continue this discussion in class.